Hello and welcome. I'm Mrs. Wheeler and this is Mrs. Wheeler Wednesday. I'm not sure how this happened, but it's December already. What's your favorite Christmas song?
Go Tell Little Mouse.
Oh, mine is. It won't be long before I'll be there with snow. Since it is now December, it is a little more socially acceptable to start listening to Christmas music. You've got Mariah, Bublé, Pentatonix. Nothing can truly compete with the sounds of Bing Crosby's 1945 album, Merry Christmas. If you've been watching for a while, you know by now that we're not just going to start here, but we have to go a little further back in time. 1857, the first record is technically created. 1930, RCA Records launches the first commercial vinyl record. It was kind of a big failure though, because no one could afford a way to play the record during the Great Depression. Whoopsie! 9 years later, Columbia Records hires Alex Steinweiss as a art director, graphic designer, and he has a groundbreaking idea. Up until this point, records come in really thin, dull-colored papered sleeves. So Steinweiss says to this, there's no sales appeal, there's no push, who the hell is gonna buy this? Those graphic designers, they're pretty smart. It took a ton of convincing to the record company on his part that the increased cost to print would be worth how much more they were gonna make in record sales. One of his first album designs, oh, this is wild, bonkers, crazy, increased the record's sales by 800%. Let's just say the record company was convinced. 1945, Bing Crosby releases his record, Merry Christmas, and you'll notice that the original artwork actually had a light blue background and his floating head was in black and white. 1948 is a big year for records and album design. The LP record is created. These records use a folded over board sleeve, which creates a larger canvas for artists and designers to experiment with. Prior to that, the paper of the sleeves was actually messing up the grooves in the records. Glad we fixed that. But it's because of that that they re-released Bing's Christmas album in 1949. Over the years, it has been re-released a number of times. In 1955, we get four new songs on the album along with a new look. One that we might be familiar with today. We have Serif Type on the top. And one of my favorite things is the way that the letters tilt ever so slightly to give you that fun sense of movement. We've got the white background, great balance, and then Bing's little head just floating there with his Santa hat. So festive and fun. It wasn't until 1986 that the album's name actually changed to White Christmas, which many of us might be familiar with today. Homework this week. We would like you to share your favorite holiday album with us. It doesn't have to be vinyl or even a physical copy. It could certainly be digital or whatever you're listening to on music these days. But don't forget to tag us and use the hashtag so we can give you a grade. And that concludes this week's lesson of Mrs. Wheeler Wednesdays. Say bye-bye.